In my last class, we discussed a voltage source inverter feeding various types of loads. And we found that if the load power factor is lagging, the self-commutating devices should be used as the switching elements in the inverter. Okay? Self-commutating devices such as MOSFETs, BJT, IGBT or GTO. Okay. These are the devices which can be turned off using gate. And in case SCRs are used as switching elements, a separate force commutating circuitry is required to turn off the conducting thyristor. I told you that this force commutating circuitry is nothing but a separate LC circuit. Hence, an inverter made up of thyristors or SCRs becomes a bit bulky. Hence, they are not very popular. Whereas, if the load power factor is leading, SCRs can be used as switching elements. In fact, if the load power factor is leading, inverter with SCRs is very attractive because SCRs are a bit rugged, cheap compared to the other devices. Another observation that we made was, if an ideal inverter feeding the ideal inductor, the input source or input voltage source can be a capacitor which is charged to a required value. For part of the cycle, this SCR, this capacitor charges or load is supplying back the energy to the capacitor, and for some part of the cycle the capacitor supplies power to the load, and over the cycle the average voltage remains the same. Okay. And in case if I take the non-idealities into account, non-idealities of the inverter as well as the inductor, the power input, the real power input to this inverter is very small compared to the output kVAR. Remember, the real power input is very small compared to the output kVAR. Okay? This real power input is used to overcome the device losses and the I square losses that are taking place in the inductor. By the way, we had used this equipment, in the sense a bidirectional or a converter using bidirectional devices and a capacitor at the output. We had used it for power factor improvement. See, recall, I have redrawn the circuit here. So here is the circuit. Source feeding a lagging load. Okay. So this unit is made up of bidirectional power devices, okay, and a capacitor is connected at the output. Okay. Now this is nothing but a voltage source inverter. This is a voltage source inverter. I can assume that this input, this is an input, and here is the output. Okay. See, in fact, we had derived an equivalent circuit. Two voltage sources are interconnected by an inductor, and I wrote the expression for the power transfer. It is V1, V2 divided by XS into sine delta. Okay. So, and I told that this voltage at this point is AC, is a a pulse width modulated waveform. Okay. So this is again, I'll repeat, this is a voltage source inverter with a capacitor as the input, and the output is available at this point. The real power transferred by the source to this inverter is very small, just to overcome the inverter losses and I square R of the inductor. And I also told you that this unit can supply both leading as well as lagging current by controlling the magnitude of this voltage, magnitude of the output voltage of this inverter, voltage source inverter. This is a very important equipment. Okay. In the last class, we had started discussing a three-phase inverter, which has three legs, okay, or six devices. See, here is it. We had taken the center point of the DC link as the reference point. Sometime later, we will find that this is not required. Remember, we can take the negative DC bus as the reference point. See, I have shown the switching elements as S1, S3, S5, S4, S6 and S2. I have not shown an anti-parallel diode across the switch. So in any VSI, S1 implies a controllable device, okay, and an anti-parallel diode connected across it. Okay. I had told you that the switching signals for S1 and S4 are complementary. Similarly, S3, S6, S5, S2. Whereas switching signals for S1 and S3, they are displaced by 120 degrees. When these switches are on, the voltage of potential A, when these switches are on, potential of A, B and C with respect to O is known. Okay. Therefore, these voltages, in the sense VA0, VB0, VC0, are known as pole voltages. Okay. I will repeat, VA0, VB0, VC0 are pole voltages. Okay. The waveform of pole voltages is a square wave of 180 degree duration. Okay. See, VA0, VB0, VC0, all are square waves of VDC by 2, because voltage we have drawn with respect to the center point of the DC link. Okay. Whereas magnitude of line to line voltage VAB or VCA or BBC is the full DC link voltage. I will repeat, magnitude of the line to line voltage is equal to the magnitude of the DC link. Okay. But the waveform is, or in each half cycle, the magnitude is VDC for only 120 degrees. For remaining 60 degrees, it is 0. See here, VAB is magnitude of VAB is VDC from 0 to 2 pi by 3, and from 2 pi by 3 to pi radians, VAB is 0. What does it indicate? It indicates that potential of A is equal to potential of B. Okay. So, if you see in this figure, I said potential of A is same as potential of B. So, these both the points could be connected to either the positive DC bus or to the negative DC bus. See, when S1 and S3 are on, both S1 and S3 are on, VAB is 0, Similarly, when S4 and S6 are on, VAB is again 0, because this point is gets connected to the negative DC bus, again B also gets connected to the negative DC bus. Okay. But then which device is conducting, whether the controllable switch is carrying the current or the anti-parallel diode is carrying the current, that we will see while drawing the current waveform. Okay. So how do I draw the current waveform? Now I'll assume the load is delta connected, okay, wherein the phase voltage is same as the line voltage. Okay. So if I know the line voltage and if I know the nature of load, it is possible to draw the phase current, remember. Okay. So phase current in the delta connected load is phase voltage divided by the impedance of that branch. Okay. I will assume load to be inductive, RL circuit. Okay. So IAB is VAB divided by Z. Okay. Current flowing from A to B, I'll repeat, current flowing from A to B is VAB divided by Z. Okay. So at steady state, a positive voltage is applied from 0 to 2 pi by 3. So current increases. If it was negative initially, it becomes positive. Okay. And at 2 pi by 3, okay, S3 is turned on, so therefore VAB becomes 0. Okay. So for an RL circuit wherein say some current is flowing, now voltage is made 0, input voltage is made 0, therefore current decays slowly. Okay. Voltage is 0, current is positive. Okay. So which of the devices are carrying current? We'll go back to the previous circuit. Voltage applied is 0, current is positive, current is flowing from A to B. Okay. So current is flowing in this fashion, A through the load, B and back here. So the controllable switch in S1 and the freewheeling diode of S3 are carrying current. See, a current IAB is positive. Okay. Because S1 and S3 are turned on, they are conducting. Current is positive. Current is flowing from A to B. So S1, but the switch, controllable switch, A to B through the load and back, it has to flow in this fashion. So it is flowing through the anti-parallel diode of S3. So knowing the voltage waveform or knowing the switches which are on and the polarities of the current, or sorry, the sign of the current, if I know the sign of the current, it is possible to determine the devices which are carrying that current. Okay. So similarly, from pi to another 120 degrees, current is become negative because a negative voltage is applied. So this is about IAB. In delta connected load, in order to draw the line current waveform, I need to know the phase current waveforms of two phases, or to draw the line current waveform that is flowing through the line A, I need to know IAB and I need to know ICA. Okay. Now ICA I can draw if I know VCA and Z. Okay. See, this is VCA waveform. On the similar lines, I have drawn ICA current waveform. VCA is 0, current decays, VCA is negative, current becomes negative, then again becomes 0, decays becomes. Now IA, I can determine by applying KCL at this point. So I will get a waveform something like this. Okay, yeah, you need to just add these two waveforms, it is easy. What observation can I make from this line current waveform? We can see that there are 6 steps in a cycle. There are 6 steps in a cycle. Okay. I told you that pole voltages VA0, VB0, VC0 are of 180 degree duration. And it is an odd function. What is the harmonic spectrum? Harmonic spectrum, it has all odd harmonics. It is given by this expression. See 4 by pi Vd by 2 is the magnitude, sin omega t 1 over 3 sin 3 omega t, so on. Whereas the line to line voltage waveform has a 0 voltage period for 60 degrees. I will repeat, a line to line voltage waveform has a 0 voltage period of 60 degree duration. So if I write the Fourier series to this waveform, it looks something like this. It looks something like this. How do I write? One way is, I will write VA0, I have written VA0 here, similarly I will write VB0, okay, and I will add VA0 minus VB0 is VAB, okay, or write a Fourier series for this waveform, simple. What observations that we can make from this, from these two expressions? The pole voltages have all odd harmonics, whereas line to line voltage waveforms have only 6n plus or minus 1 harmonics. It has a fundamental and has all 6n plus or minus 1 harmonics. In other words, 5th, 7th, 11th, 13th, so on. What is the RMS value of the line to line voltage waveform? What is the RMS value? See, it is a square wave for 120 degree duration, and for remaining 60 degrees it is 0 in the positive half. So RMS value of this is nothing but square root of 2 pi by 3 into the magnitude VDC. VDC. So this should be VDC. And what is the fundamental component of this waveform? See, this is the expression for VAB. Okay. So fundamental component is this component, sin omega t component. Okay. So 2 into root 3 by pi into VD is the peak of the fundamental component. Is the peak of the fundamental component. So RMS value of the fundamental component is root 6 by pi. Okay. See, 2 root 3 by pi into VD is the peak of the fundamental. Peak of the fundamental. RMS value is divided by root 2. So 0.78 times the DC link voltage, VDC. If I call input voltage as VDC, so it should be VDC. Okay. So this is about a three-phase inverter which is conducting for 180 degrees. In other words, each device in each leg conducts for 180 degrees. Remember, I'll repeat, each device in each leg conducts for 180 degrees, feeding a delta connected load. Now we'll replace this delta connected load by a star connected load. Okay. For a delta connected load, we need to know the line to line voltage, and from there onwards I can draw the phase current. Okay. So if the current flowing in two phases are known, I can determine the line current. Whereas in star connected load, I need to know the phase voltage waveform. Okay. How do I determine the phase voltage waveform for a star connected load? Because if when the inverted devices are on, only pole voltages are known. These pole voltages are nothing but the potential of A or B or C with respect to the center point of the DC link, with respect to O. Or I can also say that when the devices are on, the potential of A, B and C with respect to the negative DC bus is known. Okay. But then how do I get the potential of A, B and C with respect to its neutral N? See, in the circuit, these are two different points. I may be knowing the potential of these points with respect to O or the negative DC bus. Okay. But to draw the phase current, I need to know VAN or BN or CN. See, this A, B, C are connected to these points. In fact, these potential point O and point N are open. So if they are open, you can have any potential between them. Okay. By the way, see, out here I have drawn, I have mentioned as SC, SB and SCA. In the previous circuit, I have drawn 1 and 4, 3 and 6, 5 and 2. Okay. I have replaced, I am naming them as SCA, SB, SC just to determine the potential of A, B and C with respect to N. Okay. See, in a VSI, I told you that the devices are conducting for 180 degrees. In other words, SCA is conducting for 180 degrees, SCA is complementary, the lower device is conducting for 180 degrees. So at any given time, one device in each leg is conducting. I'll repeat, at any given time, one device in each leg is conducting. So at any given time, three devices are conducting. Okay. So if I know the conducting state of SCA, SB and SC, I know the conducting state of the remaining three switches because they are complementary. Okay. So there are three switches which are to be monitored. Okay, I don't need to monitor all six because they are complementary. Now these three switches, each one of them can be either on or off. Okay. So how many possible cases are there? I said the switching or the conducting state of either upper three switches or lower three switches should be known or should be monitored. Okay. So there are three switches and each switch can be either on or off. So therefore, there are eight possible cases. Okay. So the binary value is starts from 0, 0, 0. That means all three switches, the upper switches SCA, SB, SC, I can say they are off. Okay. If those three are off, the lower three are will be on. 2, 1, 1, 1. All upper switches are on and lower switches are off. Okay. So therefore, from 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, there are 8 possible states, and for each state, we will determine what is the phase voltage VAN, VBN, and VCN. Okay. Okay. I told you, you can have either 0, 0, 0 or 1, 1, 1. What happens when all three switches are off? All three upper switches are off. That means all three lower switches are on. If all three lower switches are on, point A, point B, and point C, they are connected to the negative DC bus. See in this circuit, all three switches are off. That means three switches are on. If these three switches are on, point A is connected here, point B is connected here, point C is connected here. Okay. In other words, points A, B, C are at the same potential. So therefore, VAB is equal to VBC is equal to VCA is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. Okay. So therefore, this vector 0, 0, 0 is known as a 0 voltage vector, because when all upper switches are off, the lower three switches are on, at that time the line to line voltages of all three is 0. Of all three line to line voltages are 0. Whatever the current that is flowing through the load freewheels through the negative DC bus. Okay. Same thing happens when all three switches are on. SA, SB, SC are on. The point A, B, C, now they are connected to the positive DC bus. Therefore, VAB is equal to VBC is equal to VCA is equal to 0. Load freewheels through the positive DC bus. Okay. Freewheeling means whatever the current that was flowing, it continues to flow. Okay, and path is completed through the positive bus only. Source does not supply any power. Okay, because all three points are connected to this point. Okay. Then what about the remaining six states? Okay, let's see what exactly is the voltage waveform for the remaining six vectors. I'll take SCA is on, that means upper device in phase A is on, SB and SC are 0. Okay. So the vector is 0, 0, 1. Okay. So A is on. So when A is on, point A gets connected to the positive DC bus. See in this circuit, when this switch is on, point A gets connected to the positive DC bus, and when the lower switches are on, B and C, points are get connected to, they get connected to the negative DC bus. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit, A to positive DC bus, B and C to negative DC bus, and some impedance Z is connected between the phase and the neutral, Z, Z, Z. Okay, I am taking a balanced load, so this circuit can be simplified further. A, N, now B and C are in parallel, same load, so I will write Z by 2, and this point could be either B or C. Voltage applied is VDC. So therefore, what is VAN? Okay. How do I determine VAN? See, VDC is applied across 1.5 times Z, Z plus Z by 2, 1.5 Z. Okay. So, voltage across Z is 3 by 2 times VDC, 3 by 2 times VDC. And remaining one third times the voltage, one third times the DC link voltage appears across the load connected to B and C. Okay. Now point A is at higher potential than N. Okay. So I am calling VAN as positive 2 by 3 VDC, whereas B is at the B is connected to the negative DC bus, so VBN is negative, VBN is negative. So VBN is nothing but VCN, see VBN is same as VCN, so that is equal to minus one third VDC. So we determine the phase voltages for SC is equal to 0, SB is equal to 0, and SA equal to 1. On the similar lines, I can determine the phase voltage for SC is equal to 0, SB is equal to 1, and SA is equal to 0. In the sense, only one switch in the upper half is on, and therefore the two of the remaining two phases in the lower half are on. Okay. So under this condition, the voltage of the phase in which the upper device is on is 2 by 3 VDC. And the phase voltages of the remaining two phases in which the lower devices are on is minus one third VDC. Okay. See this, only SB is 1, SA is 0, SC is also 0. So we can find that VBN is 2 by 3 VDC. See, we had 001 VAN is 2 by 3 VDC. The voltages or phase voltages of B and VBN and VCN is minus one third VDC. So here VCN and VAN is minus one third VDC. Now what happens? Two devices of the upper arm are on. Okay. See, something like this, SCA is 1, SB is 1, SC is equal to 0. Okay. So that means A and B are connected to the positive DC bus, and point C is connected to the negative DC bus. So whatever that happened for 001, its complementary should happen for 110. Okay. So when phase, seen this here, for 001 I have minus 1/3 VDC. Okay. Now if I make the complementary of this, okay, I should get just the opposite. See, for SA and SB equal to 1, it will happen that VAN and VBN are 1/3 VDC, and VCN is minus 2/3 VDC. Okay. So now I know the phase voltages for each switch combination. Okay. Now we will draw the phase voltage waveform for the entire cycle. Okay. See here, VA0, VB0, VC0. See, VA0 is on for 0 to pi, VB0 becomes VDC by 2, or S3 is turned on at 2π/3. So prior to this, S6 is on. Okay. Similarly for C phase. Now we see from 0 to π/3, you have upper switch on in phase A, lower switch on in phase B, again upper switch on in phase C. Okay. It is something like this, 1, 0, 1. Okay. So therefore, VAN is 1/3 VDC. Okay. See, we have 2 1s and 1 0. Okay. We have 2 1s and 1 0. So in this case, we have 2 1s and 1 0. So the phases which are 1s is 1/3 VDC, and which has 0, it has minus 2/3 VDC. Okay. So therefore, VAN is 1/3 VDC. What happens from π/3 to 2π/3? We have VA01, or VA0 is plus VDC by 2, or SA is equal to 1, SA is equal to 1, SB is equal to 0, SC is equal to 0. We have something like this, 0, 0, 1. So the phase voltage VAN is 2/3 VDC. Okay. And from 2π/3 to pi, we have again 1, 1, 0. Okay. So again, phase voltage drops to 1/3 VDC. So this is the positive half, so you will have similarly in the negative half. So how many steps are here? Again, there are 6 steps in a cycle. Okay. So a 3-phase inverter, in which each device is conducting for 180 degrees and the load is delta connected. So there are 6 steps in a cycle in the line current waveform. Okay. The same inverter feeding a star connected load, the phase voltage has 6 steps in a cycle. There are six steps in the cycle. Now, following the same procedure that I use to determine the line current waveform. Now, here line current is same as the phase current. It is VAN divided by Z, VAN divided by Z. I will assume RL load maybe, okay. At steady state, you have something like this, increases from positive value, sorry, increases from a negative value, becomes positive. Now I am applying 2 by 3 VDC, so rate of rise here is higher than rate of rise of current in this, because voltage applied to that load is 1/3 VDC, here is 2/3 VDC. So rate of rise is definitely is higher than that in this case, okay. At this point again a 1/3 VDC is being applied, so definitely I need to have a symmetric waveform, okay. So current decreases here and so on, okay. So again there are six steps in that cycle, there are six steps in that cycle. So a three phase inverter in which each device conducting for pi radians is known as a six step inverter, okay. Remember, what is a six step inverter? Is a voltage source inverter in which each device is conducting for 180 degrees, each device conducting for 180 degrees, okay. So if it is a load is a delta connected load, there are six steps in cycle in the line current waveform. If the load is a star connected, the phase voltage and the line current has six steps per cycle, hence the name six step inverter, okay. What are the limitations of a six step inverter? What is the harmonic spectrum, or what are the predominant harmonics that are present in the three phase three wire system? In a three phase three wire system, the line currents cannot have triplen harmonics. I'll repeat, in a three phase three wire system, the line currents cannot have triplen harmonics, okay. Therefore the frequency spectrum is 6n plus or minus 1 times the fundamental frequency. So the frequency of the harmonic component that are present is 6n plus or minus 1 times the fundamental frequency, okay. I said source is a variable voltage, variable frequency type. In other words, output voltage of the inverter should vary with frequency if the load is AC motor. I can control the frequency by controlling the on time of the device. Up till now I have not discussed as to how to vary this output voltage, okay. I have discussed it after some time, but then the fact remains, and that is the magnitude of the output voltage should change with the frequency. Now this frequency of the fundamental could be 1 hertz, say very low speed of operation, it could be 10 hertz, or it could be say 40 hertz, okay. Of course above the rated the magnitude of the voltage will remain constant. Okay. So when the fundamental frequency is 1 hertz, the frequency of the predominant harmonic is 5 hertz, 7 hertz, 11 hertz and 13 hertz. When the frequency of the fundamental is 10 hertz, the frequency of the predominant component is going to be 50 hertz, 70 hertz, so on. So therefore, listen to me carefully, since the frequency of the fundamental component is itself is changing, the frequency of the predominant harmonic also changes. Okay. So frequency of the predominant harmonic could be 5 hertz or 50 hertz or 250 hertz depending upon the frequency of the fundamental. Okay. And this frequency components have its own effect on the load. I am not going to discuss the effect of harmonics on the machine. Okay. So this topic should be handled in drives. The fact is that you have to eliminate this, or you have to filter this, the predominant harmonics. To filter this predominant harmonics, one solution is to use a filter. So when the frequency of the fundamental component is 1 hertz, I need to have a filter which blocks 5 hertz component and 7 hertz component. When the frequency of the predominant component is 10 hertz, I need to have another filter which blocks 50 hertz and 70 hertz. And if the frequency of the fundamental component is 40 hertz, I need to have another filter which blocks 200 hertz and 280 hertz. 40 into 7 is 280 hertz. So it's rather impossible to design a filter to filter out the predominant harmonics that are present in the line current when the frequency of the fundamental itself is changing. I'll repeat, it's rather impossible to filter, or it is rather impossible to design a filter which filters the predominant harmonic components that are present in the line current when the frequency of the fundamental itself is changing. Okay. So that is one limitation. Now let me address another issue in a square wave inverter or a 6-step inverter as to how to control the output voltage. I said frequency can be varied by varying the on time of the device, or the device for which, or time for which the device is on. I said if the upper device is on for 10 milliseconds, you have a 50 hertz supply. If it is on for 100 milliseconds, I have a 5 hertz supply. How do I vary the output voltage? How do I vary the output voltage? From the various waveforms, we have observed that when the device is on, the input voltage appears across the load. In other words, see, the output voltage waveform here, the magnitude of the output voltage is proportional to the input voltage VDC. Okay. Because line to line voltage waveform, the peak value is VDC, is constant for 2 pi by 3 radians. I can control the frequency. Okay. How do I control this magnitude? So if I have to vary this magnitude of VAB, I have to change the magnitude of VDC itself. Okay. So one has to change the magnitude of VDC. How do I vary this magnitude of VDC? In my very first lecture in DC to AC converter, I told you that in a inverter there has to be a AC to DC converter, because how do I get a DC power supply, or from where on earth to get this DC supply? So the input DC is generally obtained from rectifying the input AC, okay, in an inverter, or I need to store in a battery. Again, that battery has to be charged from AC supply itself. Okay. So assuming that there is a AC to DC converter, okay, the output of the AC to DC converter should be varied. Okay. So in other words, I need to have a controlled rectification at the source side. Okay. Either it could be a three-phase fully controlled bridge, or it could be a single-phase fully controlled bridge. I need to have some control over the output voltage. Okay. Yes, if I have a controlled bridge, by introducing phase angle delay, I can reduce or I can control the output voltage of the bridge, AC to DC converter. As the frequency of the DC to AC converter reduces, okay, as the frequency of the DC to AC converter reduces, I need to reduce this VDC. Okay. Okay. How to reduce this VDC and what are the various issues involved, we will see sometime later. Thank you.